So we have a new analysis technique. This is based on the Neuber correction, which allows us to do a quick and efficient plasticity evaluation. I'm sure many of you would be familiar with the Neuber correction inside in a fatigue analysis. So we use the same concept here, whereby we run a linear analysis, and we use the elastic stressor that we get from the linear analysis, along with the Neuber correction and the nonlinear material properties, and we're able to estimate what the plastic stresses and the plastic strains are. This is quick and efficient in the sense that I don't need to run a full-blown nonlinear analysis in order to get an estimate of what my nonlinear stresses are. I can do that all with a linear analysis. This same functionality is also optimization ready. So you can actually optimize for a nonlinear stress using this Neuber correction inside of OptiStruct. So on the right-hand side, you'll see, let me just put on a pointer so it's clear to see. So you'd see here's an example of a landing gear lug, and we're running a non-parametric shape optimization in order to try and keep the stresses below a certain value. And the constraint bound on that stress is actually over yield. So we're looking at a stress constraint of about 340 megapascals, and the yield of the material is 300 megapascals. And you can see if you had to run that using a typical linear approach, the linear stresses are highly overestimated. And you can see in this case they show up as 525 megapascals, whereas if we run it using the Neuber correction, we're at about 340 megapascals. And if you compare that with a full-blown nonlinear static analysis, we're at about 336. So you see that, excuse me, that there is a very good agreement between the plastic stresses and strains that you get from this Neuber correction and that of a full-blown nonlinear analysis, only at a much lower cost. We get all of this with linear analysis as opposed to running a full-blown nonlinear analysis, making it that much more efficient for optimization as well.